What a coincidence that I see you here.
The girl with the fake smile was Kaori Tendo. She and I, Tetsuya Haranishi, have not been on speaking terms for a month. But I would never believe that this would happen.
You two are in the same class, right? What a coincidence. Mom, please don't. You're embarrassing me. You two are gonna be step-siblings. It feels like destiny, doesn't it?
Apparently, Tendo's mother and my father are planning on marrying each other. That would make Tendo and me step-siblings. I heard about the idea of them getting married before. I just didn't know that it was to Tendo's mother.
Mom, I don't think it's destiny. Just be quiet. What's gotten into you? You're awfully rebellious today. You're always so nice to me. What? Mom! Stop!
Huh. She's like that at home, huh? Makes sense, honestly.
What? What is that face? It's not true.
Okay.
You're so annoying. Hey, don't be mean. Be nice to him. But... You're going to be step-siblings. You need to get along. Huh?
I think it's pretty tough considering they're the same age and different genders. Maybe it'd be a little different if they were at least a year apart in age. But I want to get along and make a happy family. So if you two have any complaints, don't hesitate to ask me, okay? Dad! What if we tell him that we used to go out? I wonder if he'll be as understanding.
Your father seems nice.
After the family meeting was over, we went out to the hallway. Kaori followed me. Yeah, he raised me all on his own.
I see. I need to ask you a favor.
Yeah?
Don't tell them that we were dating, for starters.
I agree. That would be really awkward.
Right, so we have to pretend to get along in front of them.
Huh? Why?
Don't be so negative.
I don't want to!
This is why I don't like you. If we just act normal, we're just gonna fight and argue like we are now. So we have to focus and get along. It's for our parents' sake.
I mean, you're right, but... My mother died when I was still young, so I was raised by my father. I want him to be happy from the bottom of my heart. However... get along with you?
What?
I just can't imagine it. How did we get along before?
You kind of start fights without even thinking about it. Just act normal.
What?
What is that face? Are you even trying?
Oh my gosh. Can you be a little quieter?
Why do you think I'm being loud?
What's going on, guys? Why are you yelling?
Oh, Mommy. I mean, Mom. Nothing.
Really? Are you teasing Tetsuya again?
No.
Nah, we were just chatting. I surprised her when I told her about the anime I was watching.
Sayori loves anime, so it makes sense.
Sorry, we'll be a little quieter.
It's okay, as long as you two are getting along.
What?
Thank you.
I agree that I want them to think that we get along. I'm sure it'll cause issues if we argue all the time.
Yeah, exactly. So you can pretend we get along.
Yeah, if I try, I guess.
Let's keep it up.
Are you trying to put it all on me?
No. I just wouldn't fight if you don't start the fights.
Come on. That's like I'm always the one starting something with you.
It's kind of true.
No, you start the fights often.
That's not true. You always have a chip on your shoulder. I never start fights.
No. At least a month ago...
Hmm?
You'd have to reserve the anime goods. Otherwise, you wouldn't get it.
That's true. I should have. But I'm hoping they'll resell so I can grab it then.
I'm glad you guys get along.
Is your mom a little... weird?
She's not weird. She just has her own little world.
Isn't that what you call weird? Anyway, I think it's best to just get along.
I agree. Don't talk to me unless we're around them, of course.
See, that's what I'm talking about!
What?
God, you're so annoying!
Hmm?
Man, she really was an annoying character, wasn't she? She should have considered the main character's feelings more.
I agree. I feel so bad for him.
And so, although we had broken up a month ago, we had to pretend to get along in front of our parents. As a result... What? Honeymoon?
Yeah, you two get along, so there should be no problems.
It's just a week, so you two shouldn't have any problems. Of course!
Yeah, of course it's okay.
I'll go buy souvenirs for you two.
Hey, Tetsuya, can I borrow you for a second?
Yeah.
Were you able to predict this at all?
It makes sense, but...
Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't think this would happen this quickly!
I don't want to be with just you for an entire week!
You're being dramatic!
Shut up! It's that big of a deal for me!
You realize that your mom is going to notice again if you talk too loud. Anyway, we just get through the week without talking to each other at all. We can't ask to go with them with how happy they are to get away.
I know. I wish I had a friend that I could stay with.
Too bad you're a loner.
You too!
We were both alone all the time at school. Maybe that's why we were eventually attracted to each other. Saori and I are both not good with people. We just assumed that since both of us aren't good with people, we would get along with each other. However, of course it didn't work out like that, so we broke up quickly. Anyway, we have to get through this acting like we get along. Got it?
Okay, fine.
And that's how we started pretending to get along with just the two of us, to make sure that my parents are able to go on their honeymoon.
Here.
What is this?
Can't you tell? It's food. I'm supposed to look after cooking while my mom is gone.
Your homemade cooking, huh? You didn't poison it, did you?
Cut it out! You're gonna make me angry!
You're already angry!
You should really keep that to yourself.
I'll have it since you made it for me.
Don't ignore me!
Huh. This is actually really good. I didn't know she could cook.
What?
No, I'm just surprised that your food is really good.
Can you not just be nice to me? You should just say it tastes good, thanks.
Are you happy that I'm complimenting you?
Huh?
I thought you wouldn't like me complimenting you.
Yeah, you're right. I wouldn't be happy at all if you complimented me.
Right? Thanks for the food. I'll clean it up.
That's rare. Why?
It's called sharing responsibilities. If you cooked, I'll clean.
Okay. Thanks.
We actually got along well, even though my parents weren't around. They always argued with each other, but it didn't seem like it was a huge problem. But just as I thought, something else happened.
Hey, I have to ask for something.
Kaori came into my room on the third day of just us living together. Why don't you knock if you're gonna come in? What do you need? Something was off with how she was acting. I stopped arguing and asked her what was going on.
I picked her up.
You picked her up? Seriously?
She was thrown into a cardboard box in the rain, so I just felt so bad.
I mean... Okay. Let's take her to the vet.
She's weak, but I feel like she can recover if we just give her a warm bath and some milk.
If she's really tired from the rain, maybe that'll be it. But she could have other problems that we don't know about. Besides, maybe she's got some diseases. We should get a doctor to take a look.
Okay, but it costs money and I just bought new clothes.
I'll pay.
You sure?
Yeah, we gotta do it.
Thank you.
It's not that big of a deal. It's for the cat. Not you.
Okay. Thanks.
We took a taxi that was okay with pets and headed to an animal hospital with the cat.
I'm so glad she doesn't have any problems.
She was probably just recently thrown away. I'm glad she's all right, though.
Yeah.
I haven't seen Kaori this happy in a while.
Oh.
Hmm? What's up?
Does your dad not like cats?
Oh, don't worry about it. I've never been told that we can't have pets, and we had a cat a while ago.
Oh, okay.
Head home first with the cat.
Where are you going?
We need stuff to take care of the cat. We can't take the cat to all the stores, so just go home before me.
Oh, okay. He is actually pretty kind. I went home before him and started replaying what just happened, after I saw that the cat was healthy again. When I think about it, he's always been that way. Even though he's pretty antisocial and toxic, he's pretty thoughtful. I think it all started when he got a book I couldn't reach for me. He was going to read a different book from the same genre. I figured he had a similar interest, so I talked to him. I was shocked with how nice he was, but how distant he seemed. Why did we fight again? The reason was because he was being kind to a younger student. I knew that he was just helping her because she needed the help. But at the time, I didn't like the way he was acting to her. Then one day, during a small argument, I let it slip. It slowly started getting worse, and I said things I shouldn't have said. It was probably me.
Meow!
Kitty! And you're in his bed. I mean, the kitty is in the bed, so I have to, you know. I looked around just in case and slowly got into the bed. Gotcha.
Meow.
What? You don't want to get out of bed? Okay, then let's just stay in the bed for now.
Meow.
It smells like Tetsuya. It's like I'm being held by him.
Meow.
I enjoyed the bed completely. Before I knew it, the kitty was asleep. Maybe it was sleepy because of the rain. And then, before I knew it...
Wait, why are you in my bed?
Tetsuya was home. No, this isn't what it looks like.
I'm not sure what it's supposed to be then. What are you doing in my bed?
The kitty. The kitty said it wanted to sleep in your bed.
Cats don't talk!
It's true. The kitty got into your bed.
Okay. And why did you need to get in too?
It looks really sad, so I felt like I should be around it.
Maybe you should come up with better excuses.
It's true, right, kitty?
Meow.
Oh, it ran away.
So, tell me the truth.
Because...
Hmm?
I was seduced by the cat inviting me into the bed?
What? Why are you being quiet?
I'm going to plead the fifth.
Do you still...
Don't get it wrong! Just because you were a little nice to me doesn't mean that I'm gonna fall for you!
Yeah, that's basically just admitting it. Okay, fine, whatever.
But why are you letting it go?
You're seriously still playing games.
That's kind of rude, isn't it?
You've always been that way. You like to act tough.
I'm not acting tough. Don't be weird.
Are you a cat?
Who are you calling tsundere?
Okay, calm down.
What?
She froze up when I jokingly pet her head, but she didn't try to shake my hand off. She's really not honest with herself. I didn't mind that about her, though. I did think it was a little annoying when she'd argue back, but I think it's kind of cute that she tries to hide things. It's like dealing with a cat. We were exes, and now we're step-siblings. If it was a fairy tale, maybe that's how it ends. But reality isn't that simple. Once you cut ties, it's hard for it to go back to where it was. However, you can re-tie it. So although we're just getting back to being friendly, we ended up dating again in about 6 months while raising the kitten together. Of course, my father was okay with raising the kitten, even though he was surprised when he got home.